Okay, talking about crazed, next up is Jamaal Bowman, Congressman Jamaal Bowman. He is crazed, and we have video of him yesterday, I think this is from yesterday, in the hallways of the Capitol. He has somehow, like, stationed himself at a choke point, so to speak, where there's a number of reporters standing around with their cell phones, and members of Congress are walking through this hallway, this doorway, and he's positioned himself there to make a spectacle of himself on purpose, and to do it at a point where he can get people to record him. So let's bring it up. It is as nutty as you can imagine.
And they go to the Senate, ask the same questions. They're cowards. They're all cowards. They won't do anything to save the lives of our children.
So he's ranting about he's ranting about gun control is what he's ranting about.
At all. Cowards. Pressure them. Force them to respond to the question. Why the hell?
Now, you might remember that if they wanted an assault weapon ban, the Democrats controlled Congress for the prior 2 years. Republicans have only been in charge of the House for, what, 2 months or something like that? 3 months? But for 2 years, they controlled both the House, the Senate, and the White House, and they didn't pass the assault weapons ban. Also, just a quick note, the Columbine shooting, which we've talked about before, that occurred when the assault weapons ban was in place.
You do anything to save America's children, and let them explain that all the way up until Election Day of 2024. Let them explain it all the way up to Election Day of 2024. They're free.
Because he wants to use the death of these six kids, three kids and three adults, rather, horrifically in Nashville. He wants to use this as an election issue.
Cowards. They're gutless. They're not here. I'm talking about guns.
Here comes Congressman Massie. Here comes Congressman Massie. And Massey's very bright, but he does take the bait here, which is exactly what Bowman wanted. Now, I remember like a month ago or something, Bowman got in a fight with another congressman outside the Capitol. I can't remember if that was Massie, but this is kind of Bowman's mode of operation. He tries to do these like street hysterics to get attention. And so here's Massie. You can't really hear Massie that well, but here he is.
You know, there's never been
I'm talking about gun violence
in a school that allows teachers to carry.
Oh my
carry God. Guns? You think more guns?
And this is definitely the way a congressman gets their point across, right? And he you know, he does it by screaming at people. Because this is congressional, this is professional, this is statement-like. No.
To more death! More guns lead to more death! Look at the data!
More guns to lead to more death is what Bowman says. Massie later on, and it's actually not in this clip, but Massie later on actually says that in a school that's been guarded by someone with a gun, like a police officer, Massie says there's never been a police a shooting there, even an accidental discharge. This is Steny Hoyer, the Democratic leader, coming into the frame.
Looking at any data. You're carrying the water for the gun lobby. Look at the data. More guns lead to more death.
And if he can just, you know, if you can shout down your opponent, then according to Bowman, that's winning. By the way, Bowman continues to make physical contact with Massie on a repetitive basis.
Guns! States that have open carry laws have more death! States that have open carry laws have more death!
Steny gives up. Steny's like, I can't hold this guy. Steny was trying to be the voice of reason there, and he's like, I can't, he's not listening to me.
Are you listening to what I'm saying? Calm down, children are dying! 9-year-old children! The solution is not arming teachers! Have you ever worked in a school?
Keeps on poking at him. Keeps on poking at him. In another video, you can see he really kind of handles him a little bit.
Have you ever worked in a school? Have you ever worked in a school?
So he just keeps up. Have you ever worked at a school? Because if you haven't worked at a school, then you shouldn't be part of the debate, is basically Bowman's point. He's going to ask him like 7 times.
Have you ever worked in a school? It's a yes or no question. Have you ever worked in a school? You will not answer my question. Don't stop and talk to me. Okay, I'll bring it down a notch.
Don't stop and talk to me if you've not worked in a school. I'm trying to get attention here. I'm trying to make a scene for myself. I'm trying to make myself look like a fool. I'm trying to get in front of the camera. I'm doing everything I can to get in front of the camera. Don't stop and talk to me. Don't play. He absolutely wants Massie to stop and talk to him because it's theater. It's theater for Bowman. This is theater for Bowman. That's all it is. Have you ever worked in a school? Because if you haven't worked, because you know what happens next. When Massie says no, then Bowman's going to say, well, then you don't know what you're talking about. You can't have any feelings on this if you've never worked at a school. I mean, that's what it is. But that's the Democratic response. It's to scream because they understand how they've lost the debate. Subconsciously, they understand how they've lost the debate. There are some more sophisticated members of Congress, like Catherine Clark, who was on here yesterday claiming that transgenders were the victim, right? We saw that in yesterday's story. Catherine Clark here from Massachusetts.